Hey everybody, I'm here at Velo City 2017. Armin Nijmegen, and we are here in the Netherlands, and of course it's such an exciting time to see people bicycling on protected bike lanes all over the place. There's so much going on at the conference. There are speakers and tours and vendors, and there's lots of great people and bike rides. And there's going to be a huge bike parade that you're gonna see a few shots of as I'm speaking, I'm sure. And now we're about to go on a great tour with a few Dutch intersection engineering specialists who are gonna show us some great designs and how, when bicyclists and cars interact, what are ways that you could better design the intersection. We're gonna visit a school where most children bike. We're also gonna meet the principal for a moment. I hope you enjoy this little encapsulation of what we see.
In the region, there are several fast cycling routes. This is Arnhem, this is Nijmegen. And we're gonna do the Nijmegen-Beuningen route. This is a fietsstraat, a cycle street. The maximum velocity is 30 kilometers an hour, but everyone have to adjust the behavior to the cyclist. This one says, yes. The car is a guest in the street.
And there's a lot of these I've seen around.
Yes. It's necessary because we have to repeat the message.
It's red asphalt, but it's not entirely to the pavement. We leave a little side open so the bicycles are not forced to cycle all the way to the side, but a little more in the center. So the bicycle know that they are having priority. The parking spaces are not in the same level of the normal car lane. They're elevated, and we put them on the where also the pedestrians. We have the speed bumps. We have the sign, which is specially made for these cycle streets. And apart from that, we do not have any signs at all, because we don't do that in the residential area.
Today, you are our guest at the primary school De Hoeve in Beuningen. The current bicycle lane started off as a generic road, open for all traffic. For more than 25 years, it has been a bicycle lane. But only a handful of children and parents wear helmets.
60 to 70% of our children will come by bike to school.
And what are their ages?
The ages are 4 till 12. It gives me a good feeling when I see all that children coming by bike.
Big arteries like this, and if you have to regulate it with the traffic lights with the same level with bicycles, then the traffic jams for cars will be a lot longer, and bicycles have to wait. They go through red and have hazardous situations that we try to get the bicycles off, so get them underground or elevated, or so it's better for both systems. Relatively busy artery road, maybe 8,000 car vehicles a day. Normally the cars had priority here about 3-4 years ago, and they decided to turn it around. These roads are normally used by 99% of the people who come here every day. First they just continued the red asphalt. The slopes for the cars were not very steep, and they made it once a little more steeper. This sign is also very well standard for these situations, because you can see it from a very far distance.
Yeah, it feels like a red carpet and you can go on. That's good. And you also see the big street, so it's obvious that you have to get eye contact to be sure.
It's traditionally a normal traffic light junction. This is the town of Wurt. It has two sides, and this is a very big obstruction in the middle. So people could only go from one side to the other by this point. Traffic lights, long waits, not very convenient. And every cyclist, almost every, had to stop here before the traffic lights and have to wait for cars. So they created a very big island in the middle. That has also the advantages that the cyclists can cross in multiple times. So now only the crossing is regulated with traffic lights, which means that the waiting times for this traffic light are minimal. So if you want to cross here as a cyclist or pedestrian, you push the button and within 5 seconds you can again get green light.
Yeah, I push it and it's very nice. It's very comfortable, very safe. Just go out on the green light and it's good.
This is a bicycle storage area for approximately 4,000 bicycles. It's free to park your bike here, and it's guarded.